Okay, so far we've covered quite a few things about graphing lines. Basically, we've done this by plotting points. So, for instance, if you're asked to graph the line 2x minus 3y equals 6, the method we've used is to solve for y, make a table of ordered pairs, plot them, and draw the line. So, for this problem, let's quickly do that. You could put this on pause and then check and see if you did it the same way I did. So I've got to subtract 2x from both sides. So I'm at negative 3y equals negative 2x plus 6. Divide both sides by negative 3. So I have positive 2/3 minus 2. And then we could pick any values for y. I'm sorry, for x. I'm going to choose multiples of 3 to avoid fractions. So I'm going to put in negative 3, 0, and positive 3. 2/3 times negative 3 minus 2. The 3's cancel, I get negative 2 minus 2. That's going to give me the ordered pair negative 3, negative 4. 2/3 times 0 minus 2 is going to give me negative 2. And 2/3 times 3, the 3's are going to cancel. So 2 minus 2 is 0. So using this method, we would have negative 3, negative 4, 0, negative 2, and 3, 0. Perfectly good method. You can always use this method if you can solve for y. And the only time you can't solve for y, if it's something like x equals 3, remember, and then you just put a bunch of ordered pairs where x is always 3, and you'll get that vertical line. Every other line that has a y in it, you're able to solve for y and plot points like this. Okay, so now what we're going to do is graph this line using a different method, which actually is a little bit easier. Okay, so a second method for graphing equations of this form is to plot the x and y intercepts. Now, the best time to use this method, plotting by using x and y intercepts, is when it's not solved for y. Okay, so for this problem here, 2x minus 3y equals 6, it's not solved for y. So instead, what we're going to do is notice that, well, on the graph, on the x-axis, y is always 0. You never go up or down. So if you want to find a point on the x-axis, you know that the y value is always 0. So every single ordered pair on the x-axis is something 0. Every ordered pair on the x-axis. On the y-axis, you don't go left or right at all. X is always 0. So here's what we have. Okay, since every ordered pair on the x-axis has the form something 0, note y is always 0, this is how we're going to find the x-intercept. The x-intercept means where does the line cross or go through the x-axis. We're going to plug in y equals 0. So we have this equation. To get the x-intercept, of 2x minus 3y equals 0, let y equal 0. Okay, so if we're going to let y equal 0, so let's do that. We're going to plug in 0 for y to get the x-intercept. So let's go over here and plug in 0 for y. That just says 2x is 6, so x is 3. Now we know it goes through the point 3, 0. Now, to get the y-intercept, it's the same idea. The y-intercept of 2x minus 3y equals 6. If it's on the y-axis, x is always 0. So we're going to let x equal 0. Okay? So we put in 2 times 0 minus 3y equals 6. Be careful of your negative sign. You need to divide by negative 3. Y is negative 2. That's the value. When x was 0, y was negative 2. All right, so what do we get? The x-intercept was 3, 0. And the y-intercept was 0, negative 2. So let's see what this graph looks like. Let's remember the equation. It was 2x minus 3y is 6. All right, so let's plot the x-intercept. That means it's on the x-axis, 3, 0. And the y-intercept's on the y-axis, 0, negative 2. Now here's where you have to be really careful. Graph the line. Use a straight edge and kind of mark where it seems to be going through other points, because that's how we're going to check it. So we've got that, we have 2 points, 3, 0, and 0, negative 2. And you want to make sure the line's really going through the correct point. So this point over here, what is this? This looks like 6, 2. That's the point 6, 2. Is 6, 2 a solution? Well, let's see. 2 times 6 minus 3 times 2. Does that equal 6? Remember how we do that? We plug in 6 for x, 2 for y. 12 minus 6 equals 6. Yep. So this looks like the correct line. 2x minus 3y equals 6. And so to plot the x and y intercept, to get the x-intercept, you put in 0 for the y. To get the y-intercept, you plug 0 in for the x. Okay, so if you have an equation of a line, to find the x-intercept, let y equal 0. You're going to get an ordered pair. And then to find the y-intercept, let x equal 0. Get a different ordered pair, graph both points, and do a checkpoint. By a checkpoint, my checkpoint was 6, 2 up here. I have to see, make sure that another point that it went through was really a solution to the equation. Now, this only works if the x and y intercept are different. If it goes through the origin, that's only one point and you're never going to get a line. So this isn't going to work unless it doesn't go through the origin. All right, so let's do another example. All right, so how would we find the x-intercept and the y-intercept of the line 5x minus 3y equals 15. To get the x-intercept, I have to put in 0 for y. So write an ordered pair and immediately put in 0 for y. And now we're going to take the equation, 5x plus 3y equals 15, plug in 0 for y. All right, now when you put in 0 for y, hopefully you'll notice that's just 5x plus 0. So 5x is 15, x will be 3. So now we have our answer for the x-intercept. All right, y-intercept. We're going to put in 0 for x. So immediately you write an ordered pair, putting in 0 for x. Again, write the equation of the line. Now, if you put in 0 for x, we get just 3y equals 15. Now, be careful. If this was a minus 3y, you would have negative 3y equals 15. But it's positive, so 3y equals 15. Y is 5. So that goes in for the y value of the ordered pair. And now we also have our y-intercept. Okay, keep in mind that when you're using this method, the x and y-intercepts, it's just that you're getting 2 points and plotting them, just like before, except they're specifically the x-intercept and the y-intercept, because those are easy computationally, putting in a 0 for x and then just putting in a 0 for y. So let's graph these. We have 3, 0, and then we have 0, 5. And then I have to graph this very carefully. I think that's where it's going to go through. Okay. All right, looks like it's going through this point 6, negative 5. Let's check it. You want to make sure that's really on the line. So here's my checkpoint. So we're going to put in 6 for x, negative 5 for y, that's the question. 30 plus negative 15 equals 15. Yes, it's true. The other way to do it is to just take the original equation and plug in any other number for x and solve for y and plot that third point. But you do want to have 3 points on the line to check in that equation.